Hi, in this video, we are going to talk about how to automate Excel reporting in Python programming language. Here we have two data files, which the link of these two data is in the description below. And if I open this file, you can see that it has two sheets, first class 1 and the second class 2. So we can see there are some students, and this is the student ID column. And these students are from class 1. And these are the marks of these students for math and physics. And also we have another class, class 2, which you can see it is class 2. And these are the student ID. And these are the marks of these students on math and physics respectively. And also we have another data, which is data 02, which you can see this is the data of class 3. These are the student ID. And these are the marks of these students for math and physics. So first of all, we need to read those data. In order to read those data, we need to use the pandas package in Python programming language. So first of all, we need to import pandas package. We import pandas as pd, and this pd is an alias name for this pandas package. So we simply type pd.readExcel because you want to read an Excel file, and then we should pass the path of these files. So first of all, I should right click on it. I should go to properties and security. And here we can see the absolute path of this Excel file. So I should pass the path of this file, and I store the results in a variable, let's say called df1. But remember that this data, that this Excel file has two sheets. So I should specify which sheet I want to store in df1, I mean the class one. So I should specify that I want the sheet which its name is class one. And also, similarly, we are going to store the results of sheet 2, which its name is class 2, in a variable, let's say, called df2. And similarly, we are going to use the data, which its name is data 02, and it has a sheet called class 3, and we want to name the result df3, I mean data frame 3. So now we want to aggregate, or let's say concatenate, these three data frames. So we simply type pd, and this pd is the alias name for pandas package. So we simply type pd.concat because you want to concatenate these three data frames, which we should specify in this list. So we simply type df1, df2, and also df3. And then we want to store the result in a variable, let's say called df. So this data frame contains all the data from all the three classes. So maybe you want to save this concatenated data into an Excel file. So you simply type df.2excel because you want to save it as Excel. And you should specify the path. So for example, I copy this, and I change the name to, for example, let's say total. And if I run the code, and if I go to the folder and open the file, you can see there it is. The files have been concatenated. But as you can see, we have a column, which Pandas calls it index, which is not very beautiful. So if you want to drop this column, you can simply type index. You can simply type index equals false. It means that you don't want the index column. So if you run the code again, it says permission denied because the file is now open. So I should close it, then I should run the code. So if I run the code now, and if I go to the folder, you can see that the index has been deleted. But now let's group by the data, or in Excel's terminology, let's create a pivot table in order to compare these three classes and see which class is doing better on math and which class is doing better on physics. So that's so simple. We simply type df.groupby because you want to group the data, and by which column? We want to group the data by a column called class. And also after grouping the data by the class column, we want to calculate the mean. For example, we want to calculate the mean of the math marks of class 1, of class 2, of class 3, and also the same for the physics. And we want to store the result in a variable, let's say called result. So here, if I print the results, and if I run the code, you can see there it is. But as you can see, we have a column called student ID, which is not very meaningful. We don't want to average this column. So we simply type result is equal to, because we want to update the result variable. And we want to say, we just need the math column and the physics column. So we simply type df.loc. We use this loc in order to address the location. We want all the rows and just the math column and the physics column. So now if I run the code, you can see there it is. we have two columns, math and physics. And it's very obvious that class one is performing better on physics, maybe the teacher is better, and the class two is performing better on math, and the class three is performing well on both math and physics. And now suppose that we want to add a bar plot to our report in order to better clarify the results. So we want to plot something. In order to do so, we should use a package called Matplotlib and Python, which is a package for plotting. So we simply type import matplotlib.pyplot as plt, and then we simply type results.plot because you want to plot something, and the kind is going to be bar because you want to plot a bar plot. Then we simply type plt.show in order to show the bar plot. And if I run the code, you can see here is the output. And from this bar plot, you can obviously see that the class one is performing better on physics, class two is performing better on math, and class three is performing well on both physics and math. Now I really suggest you to watch this video, which is on the screen now.